Agent, Shalom family, told out y'all family, may the peace of y'all come upon you. We learn to obey him. This is a very important video I have to do at this time, brothers and sisters, and we're going to get ready into it, brothers and sisters. And the title of this video at this time is called Blessings is Going Home to Zion. Blessings will come and flow to us, brothers and sisters, when we obey Yah. These are the words of Yah I'm about to share with you, brothers and sisters. First, I'm going to come from this particular translation called the Scriptures at this time. From the 18th chapter of Genesis, Bereshit, and verse 17 to 19. It's very important because we're going to see what Yah said to Abraham. A very important statement. And this should be in all of our minds as I give it unto you this day, brothers and sisters. Because we are the seed of Abraham. So let's get into chapter 18 of Genesis, verse 17. It says, and Yah said, shall I hide from Abram what I am going to do, what I am doing? Since Abraham is certainly going to become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. For I have known him, so that he command his children and his household after him. See, after him, to guard the way of Yah, to do righteousness and right ruling, so that Yah bring to Abraham what he has spoken to him. See, brothers and sisters, in order for all of this to come to pass, and what all the things Yah told Abraham what he was going to do for him, and how he was going to bless his seed, and through his seed, all the earth shall be blessed in him. See that? See what I said? It said, for I have known him, so that he command his children and his household after him to guard the way of Yah. That's what I've been putting in your mind, brother and sister, when I say guard the way of Yah. See, all the instructions of Yah give us to live by, we are to guard, to keep, to protect, to observe, hold fast to, defend the way of Yah. Is that to do righteousness and right ruling, see? Bring forth righteous judgment, so that Yah brings to Abraham what he has spoken to him. See, it is upon us to do righteousness and right ruling, to bring forth righteous judgment, so that Yah, that's my son Yah in the background, so that Yah will bring all of these things, brothers and sisters. See, Yah's not going to do everything for us, but he will bring things in the past based on us obeying him, complying to the order, the instruction that he gave to Abraham right there. It's not that we sit here. See, Christian attitude and religion taught us to be complacent, to wait, to do nothing. I'm just relaxed. I'm going to a 9-to-5 job. But you go to a 9-to-5 job to do for your enemy, or your own job to do for yourself, but not concerning the things of Yah. That through us, right here, brothers and sisters, let's read it. Because Abraham is certainly going to become a great nation and a mighty nation. See, he was going to become great and a mighty nation. See, the great and mighty nation is the people that bring forth right rulings of Yah and walk in righteousness, brothers and sisters. See, for this, for you to be a part of this, prophecy right here, you got to right here walk up right before Yah and bring forth right ruling. Nothing false. Everything got to be detailed. fan, it's right here. See, so that Yah bring to Abraham what he has spoken to him. See, Yah would not do these things until that group of Abraham's seed walk up right before Yah and bring forth right ruling. Then Yah said, all of these things will take place and the earth shall be blessed. See, and all the nations, not some of the nations, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. See, in Abraham's seed. Because we are the seed of Abraham. Don't let none of these distractions of the earth trick you, brothers and sisters. What the European people bringing forth, all the after sports and all. Don't allow that to captivate your mind. Because we are the ones that hold our own nation up. We are held back the blessings from us, and also the nation's blessings will not come on them. We got to look at ourselves and get our own hearts right, family. That's why we got to pull away from the nation and obey. Then they will come to us. The scriptures say that, brothers and sisters, I'm going to go into the heart of my message right now. Because this is to build and repair the brothers, the sisters. Right here, the living Bible, come from the living Bible, and the rest is coming from Psalms. I'm going to start off with Psalms 135, chapter 135, 135, verse 13 to 21. Give me a moment, let me get there, brothers and sisters, bear with me. Right here, I'm going to get right into it, chapter 13. And show you some things of Yah that is very important right here. These things are important to Yah. These are his words. They did to Yah. That I give unto you is right here. Let me give my hand on my place. It say, for Yah, they got Jehovah, but it's Yah. Your name endures forever. See, this is the writer giving praise to Yah. Your fame is known in every generation. For Yah, see, I said his fame, the things he done, the knowledge of Yah is known in every generation. For Yah will vindicate his people, see, and have compassion on his servants. See, his people are his servants. That's why I can say I'm the servant of Yah. His people are his servants that serve the will of Yah, the ways of Yah. Remember, he said, God, the ways of Yah. We got to be a servant to Yah, to God, the ways of Yah. We got to practice the ways of Yah. We got to make right rulings. We can't lie concerning the things of Yah, brothers and sisters. So right here, he's saying, I have compassion on his servants. He said, the heathen worship idols. See, the nations worship idols. Point blank. I'll be telling you that right now. They don't worship Yah at this time. They worship idols of gold and silver made by men. Idols with speechless mouths, sightless eyes, ears that cannot hear. They cannot even breathe. Those who make them become like them. And so do all who trust in them. See, remember y'all said the earth is in deep darkness, but we must draw to the light of Yah. So keep that in mind, brothers and sisters, that is very important. Verse 19. It said, oh, Yahshua, Yah, the time of the whole nation. Bless Yah, high priest of Ur. Bless Yah, O Levite priest. Bless Yah. Right here, they got Lord Yah, Lord Jehovah. But it's bless Barah Yah. Oh, bless his name. See, praise his name. Hallel his name. All of you who trust and reverence him. See how I say all of you who trust and reverence him? Because the whole nation is not going to trust and reverence y'all. That point blank, you see that, brother and sister. He said, all those who reverence him. All the people of Yah Shalom. Praise Yah. For he lives here in Yah Shalom. Hallelujah. See, the writer would say this in his time he was dead. He was reminding the people to praise Yah. All who trust in Yah. See, everybody at that time didn't trust. You see that? That's why we got put it out of the land. As I'm going to go. I got to read all the Psalms. From 121 to 129. Now, I hope I can get all of this in this video. There are a lot of short chapters. So I'm going to get right into it because as much is in there that you may see. It says, shall I look to the mountains, God? See how they got mountain gods? See how they got a little G? The creator is not a god, but the word God is referring to idols. Elohim. See, it says, shall I look to the mountain gods for help? No. See, I'm telling you, we should not look to the mountain gods, the idols, the gods. They serve the Elohim for help. No. He said, my help is from Yah. You get that? I got to show you something, brother. I never seen this written like this before. They made a huge mistake, kid. See, now you're going to see something. I read that scripture earlier. I didn't see this. But look at this word right here. You know how they say Jehovah? Look what they put at here this time. Unbelievable. Jehovah. You see that? We all can see that to verify what it's say. They got Jehovah. See, the creator name is Yah. But they and they mistake in their writings. They put Jehovah. Now look, see how they got Yah there. Right below it, they got Jehovah. You see that? They did that. They turned that V into a Y. Let me make sure that's not what my ink pen marking. So I can't tell what it looked like. They got a wide it. Cause I know I could put my ink pen down and mess around and made a mark, but that's what it looked appeared. Say, who made the mountains and the heavens too? The heaven too. He would never let me stumble, slip, or fall. So I'm gonna actually put that marker that wide is different. So I might add my ink pen on that V. He said, for he is always watching, never sleeping. He said, Yah himself is caring for you. He is your defender. He protects you day and night. He keeps you from all evil and preserve your life. He keeps his eyes upon you as you come and go and always guards you. See, these are all Yah promises for us. So we need not to fear. I'm gonna keep on reading. 122, a psalm. He said, I was glad for the suggestions of going to Yah Shalom, to the temple of Yah. See, I'm giving you all the recounts of what these brothers are witnessing and what they was practicing and what they was experiencing and how they was giving honor to Yah. See, he said, I was glad for the suggestion of going to Yah Shalom, to the temple of Yah. He said, now we are standing here inside the crowded city. All Yashayel, Yah's people have come to worship as the law required. See, to thank and praise Yah. Look, there are the judges holding court beside the city gates, deciding all the people's arguments. See, it's a pray for the people, pray for the peace of Yah Shalom. See, that's what they were saying at that time. We got to go back to Yah Shalom, where we get our peace and rest from. It said, may all who love this city prosper. O Yah Shalom, may there be peace within your walls and prosperity in your palaces. This I ask for the sake of all my brothers and my friends who live here. And may there be peace as protection to the temple of Yah. See, this is at the lifetime. The one that wrote the Psalms and reminders to the people. They were praying for the peace for the people. The one that can't and gave it to Yah. That's why these words are recorded for you. All these letters that was written. 123. It's an old Barak enthroned in heaven. I lift my eyes to you. We look to Yah, our Barak, our creator, for his mercy, see, and kindness. Just as a servant keeps his eyes upon his master, or a slave girl watches her mistress for the slightest signal. Have mercy on us, Yah. Have mercy, for we have had our fill of contempt and of the scoffing of the rich and proud. See that? How the proud were beating them down, the rich and proud of that day, at that time, were beating down those who were suffering. 124. It said, if Yah had not been on our side, let all Israel admit it. If Yah had not been on our side, we would have been swallowed alive by our enemies. See, that is true to us today. Because we was in their grip. Destroyed by their anger. See? We would have drowned beneath the flood of the men, fury and pride. See, we all can relate to this. And their generation to our generation. It's a blessed be Yah who has not let them devour us. He completely wiped us out. We have escaped with our lives as a bird from a hunter's snare trap. And the snare is broken, and we are free. Our help is from Yah who made heaven and the earth. 125. It said, those who trust in Yah are steady as Mount Zion, unmoved by any circumstance. Pay careful attention to this verse right here. It said, just as the mountains surround the protected Yah Shalom. Keep that in mind. It's showing you the layout, the geography, and appearance, and what to look for, and where, when we get back home, we know where to look for, because Yah Shalom is surrounded by mountains. It's right here, brothers and sisters. Just as the mountains surround and protect Yah Shalom, so Yah surrounds and protects his people. See that? So keep that in mind. Meditate on this, brother and sister. It's very important right here, statement. For the wicked shall not rule the righteously. See, they got godly, but it's the righteously. Lest the righteously be forced to do wrong. You see that? That's why we cannot stay in the hand of America, because you'll be forced to do wrong. You see that? Oh, Yah, do righteous to those who are righteous. It's not good, but they got it as righteous. Who hearts are right. See right there? What it really is not good. Who hearts are right with Yah. But lead evil men to execution. And let Yashayel Yah have quietness and peace. You see how people were speaking on our behalf back then, brothers and sisters? And they on behalf too. That's wisdom. 126, it's when Yah brought back his exile to Yah Shalom. It was like a dream. See, this time before, when it was in captivity, how we laughed and sang for joy. And the other nations said, what amazing thing Yah has done for them. Yes, wonderful things. What wonder, what joy may we be refreshed. As by the stream in the desert. See, renewed. It said, those who sow tears shall reap joy. Yes, they go out weeping, crying, seed for sowing, and returning singing, carrying their sheaves. See, to refer to carrying their sheaves, our children back to Zion. 127. It said, unless Yah build a house, the builder works is useless. This is very important. Unless Yah protects a city, sentries do not profit. It is senseless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, fearing you will starve to death. See, that's a very important thing that I want to share that with you and expound on that. See, when we get back home, it's other scripture to tell you about the nighttime. It's time to rest. You're going to be with your family or whatever and do you with your family. The daytime, we should rise up early and get all our work in. That's what the Shoney Red did. Don't try to labor just for the purpose to get rich. You got days on end. See, when everything back, we in our back in our right setup, everything will be done according to the will of Yah. You will never have to worry about the rent and all this foolishness what we do in America. See, right here say, it is sinless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, fearing you will starve to death. See, that's a lot of fears of our people. That's one of the fears why our people don't want to rally. He said, for Barak wants his loved ones to get their proper rest. You see that? Children are a gift from Barak. This will lead me into doing this video. See, children are a gift from Barak. They are his reward. Children born to young men are like sharp arrows. So keep that in mind. See, they are a gift, but what we doing with this gift of Yah? And we not rallying and knowing what time it is. And we being forced to do all the foolishness for the ones that hate us. See? You're forced to do a lot of things right now. And that's why you got the fears. You can't live a normal life in captivity. This is a fact, brothers and sisters. It said children are a gift from Barak, the creator. They are his reward. Children born to young man are like sharp arrows to defend him. See what this means right here, bro? This is a very important statement. Children is born to young men, are like a sharp arrow to defend him, to defend his parents, sons. I'm giving you the order of Yah, the purpose of all Yah have you. See, right here, this word is a falsification of a word to use. It's a great is a man who has his quiver full of them. See, his quiver, his home full of sons. See, the man shall have help he needs when arguing with his enemies. See, that's a very important statement. Let me see, though, they got a footnote right here. They got, let me see. His enemies. Hey. I'm looking for A. They got, okay, we sold A here. It's not that one. When he speaks with their enemies in the gate. See, when he speaks with his enemies in the gate. See, we got enemies. And brothers and sisters, see, this is what your sons and father relationship should be tight. See, but when you're not walking in righteous, when you're not rallying with me, brothers and sisters, you prohibit all of these things, the righteous orders of Yah. These are the things you've never been taught in religion. Brothers and sisters, the leaders will tell you a half of a story, but they will take your money and go live in a rich house while you go back to a poor house. And you'll watch him on the monitor riding in his fancy cars, keep telling you about unity and safety and peace. But you're not dwelling in the same area he's dwelling in. Eating the same foods he's eating in. At the same price and cost. These are the things you got to think about, brothers and sisters. It won't be that way with me. Because I know the hardship and I saw the evil ones. See right here, let me read that again. He said, "Is the man, wonderful is the man, great is the man who has his quiver full of them, see, sons. That man shall have help he need when arguing with his enemies." You see that? His back. He will have his sons to back him, brothers and sisters. So let me keep reading. It said, right here, it's 128. It said, "Blessings on all who reverence and trust Yah, on all who obey him. Their reward shall be prosperity." See that? And gladness. Shalom. "Your wife shall be content in her home and look at all those children dead. They sit around the dinner table as vigorous and healthy as young olive trees." He said, that is Barah's reward to those who reverence and trust him. You see that? How are y'all going to reward you with this woman, this wife of yours, will be content to be home, not to be loose and run out and screw everyone, all and all strange people business. She'll be content at home. See, Abiyah will be restored us to our people when we obey him, brothers. He said, that is Barah's reward. See, it's his reward to those who reverence and trust him. See, you got to trust him. That means you got to get in there and meditate on the word, be focused and willing to obey him. He's telling you the branch is coming to rattle you. He told you that. And we're at that door. We're here now. At that time, I'm here to declare that to you. It's a may Yah continuously bless you with heaven's blessings. You see that? As well as with man's joys. See the things you like. May you live to enjoy your grandchildren. And may Barah bless Yashayah Yah. See our nation as we obey him. So let me get this right here, brothers and sisters. I hope I can get all this in this video and about the piece about Dawi I want to share with you. So I'm going to speed through some right here real quick. He said, and persecuted from my earliest youth, Yashayah Yah is speaking and faced with never-ending discrimination. Everybody know that. That's a topic on television, on all the talk shows, but not destroyed. My enemies have never been able to finish me off. Though my back is cut to ribbons with their whips, Yah is righteous, for he has snapped the chains that evil man had bound me with. May all who hate the Yahudim, they got Jews, but Yahudim be brought to ignominious defeat. You see that? May they be as grass in shallow soil, turning sear and yellow when half grown. Ignored by the reapers, the reaper, despised by the binder. And may those passing be refused to bless them by saying, Yah blessed be upon you. We bless you in Yah's name. See, we will not do that. It's a, we refuse to do them things, brother, to the one that the evil ones. So keep that in mind. Right here, it's right here, brothers and sisters. Let's get this deep right here. Psalms 132 to 143. I'm going to try to speed through this as much as possible. So meditate on this. It says, Yah, do you, Yah, do you remember? This, all of this is that we talk. Yah, do you remember that time when my heart was so filled with turmoil? I couldn't rest. I couldn't sleep, thinking how I ought to build a permanent home for the ark of Yah, a temple for the mighty one of Yashayah Yah. Then I vowed that I would do it. I made a solid promise to Yah. First, the ark was in Ephratah, then in the distant countryside of Jah. But now it will be settled in the temple, in Barah's permanent home here on earth. That is where he will go to worship him. That is where we will go and worship him. See? In that third temple, this will all come true. It said, rise, O Yah, enter your temple with the ark and the symbol of your power. It said, we will clothe the priests in white and it's the symbol of our purity. That's what people, the white people got, they turned to Puritans, but and try to apply that to them, but they unclean. It said, we will clothe the priests in white and symbol of purity. May our